The bond between brother and sister is simply unique and it's beyond description in words. The relationship between siblings is extraordinary and is given importance in every part of the world. However, when it comes to India, the relationship becomes all the more important as there is a festival called Raksha Bandhan dedicated to siblings' love. The festival is made up of two words, namely Raksha and Bandhan. As per the Sanskrit terminology, the occasion means the tie or a knot of protection, where Raksha stands for the protection and Bandhan signifies the verb to tie. Together, the festival symbolizes the eternal love of brother and sister relationship, which does not mean just blood relationship only. It is also celebrated among cousin, sister and sister-in-law, fraternal aunt and nephew and other such relations. The ritual is observed on the full moon day of Hindu month of Shravan, on which sister tie the scared Rakhi string on their brother's right wrist and pray for their long lives. In northern India, Rakhi Purnima is also called Kajri Purnima or Kajri Navami, the time when wheat or barley is sown and goddess Bhagavati is worshipped. In western states, the festival is called Nariyal Purnima or the coconut full moon. In southern India, Shravan Purnima is an important religious occasion, especially for the Brahmins. Raksha Bandhan is known by various names, Vishtarak, the destroyer of venom, Punya Pradayak, the bestower of boon, and the Pap Nashak, the destroyer of sin. The festival of Raksha Bandhan is known to have originated century before, and there are several stories related to the celebration of this special festival. Some of the various accounts related to Hindu mythology, such as Indradev and Sachi. According to ancient legend of Bhavishya Puran, once there was a fierce battle between gods and demons. Lord Indra, the principal deity of sky, rain and thunderbolt, who was fighting the battle on the side of gods, were having a tough resistance from the powerful demon king Bali. The war continued for a long time and did not come on the decisive end. Seeing this, Indra's wife Sachi went to the Lord Vishnu, who gave her a holy bracelet made up of cotton thread. Sachi tied the holy thread around the wrist of her husband, Lord Indra, who ultimately defeated the demons and recovered the Amravati. The early account of the festival described this holy thread to be a mule which were used by women for prayers and were tied to their husband when they were leaving for war. Unlike the present day, this holy thread were not limited to brother-sister relationship. King Bali and Goddess Lakshmi. As per account of Bhagavat Puran and Vishnu Puran, when Lord Vishnu won the three worlds from the demon king Bali, he asked by the demon king to stay beside him in palace. The Lord accepted the request and started living with the demon king. However, Goddess Lakshmi, the wife of Lord Vishnu, wanted to return to his native place of Vaikunth. So she tied the Rakhi around the wrist of the demon king Bali and made him a brother. On asking about the return gift, Goddess Lakshmi is asked Bali to free her husband from the vow and let him return to Vaikunth. Bali agreed to the request and Lord Vishnu returned to his place with his wife Goddess Lakshmi. Santoshima. It is said that the two sons of Lord Ganesh, namely Subh and Labh, were frustrated that they had no sister. They asked for a sister for their father, who finally obliged to their sister on the intervention of Saint Narad. This is how Lord Ganesh created Santoshima through the divine plans, and the two sons of Lord Ganesh got their sister for the occasion of Raksha Bandhan. Krishna and Draupadi. Based on account of Mahabharata, Draupadi, a wife of Pandavas, tied a Rakhi to Lord Krishna, while Kunti tied the Rakhi to grandson Abhimanyu before the epic war. The strong bond represented by Rakhi has resulted in innumerable political ties among the kingdoms and princely states. The pages of Indian history testify that the Rajput and Mughal queens have sent Rakhi. Even the Mughal kings, who, despite their difference, have accommodated their Rakhi sister by offering help and protection at a critical moment to honor the fraternal bond. Even matrimonial alliances have been established between kingdoms through the exchange of Rakhi. History has it that the great Hindu king Porus refrained from striking Alexander the Great because the latter's wife had approached his mighty advisor and tied a Rakhi on her hand prior to the battle, urging him not to hurt her husband. Thus, the Raksha Bandhan symbolizes all aspects of protection of good from evil force.